So it was inevitable. California is now suing Uber and Lyft, claiming that workers are misclassified. So what does this mean, and what does it mean for other states? AB 5, a bill that we all paid attention to last year in California. It passed last year. It was signed last year. It took effect January 1st of 2020. The bill basically says that under the current working environment that drivers are under from both Uber and Lyft, they should be considered employees, not independent contractors. In order to be true independent contractors, drivers need far more control. They should be able to control rates. They also should be able to get all that information up front for a job. Each ride is a job. We should have all that information up front. And Uber and Lyft have held on to this control for years, since the beginning of Rideshare. They've been able to manipulate drivers by controlling these things. That is why AB 5 was created. That is why drivers were upset in the first place. Now, late last year, because of this AB 5 bill, Uber made some changes in California. They're now allowing drivers to see where a rider is going and an estimate of how much they'll get paid for that ride. This is a great thing and a positive step forward, and AB 5 affected that change. So AB 5 went into effect on January 1st. And Uber and Lyft have chosen not to take steps to reclassify drivers. And with this pandemic situation as it's playing out right now, granted, the government is allowing for drivers, for independent contractors, to receive unemployment benefits, but under normal circumstances, if something like this happens and the government doesn't step in, drivers are independent contractors, they're not employees, so normally they wouldn't be able to collect unemployment benefits. And that is one of the main things that AB 5 is trying to protect drivers with. And here's a quote from a New York Times article. It states, the lawsuit also claims the ride-hailing companies are engaging in unfair business practice that harms other California companies that follow the law. By avoiding payroll taxes and not paying minimum wage, Uber and Lyft are able to provide rides at an artificially low cost, giving them a competitive advantage over other businesses. This is the crux of it. Uber and Lyft have been able to play by their own rules for all of these years, and they've driven prices so low that the current business model is not sustainable for drivers, for Uber and Lyft. They're losing money every single year. Why are the prices so low? Well, early on in Rideshare, I've been a Rideshare driver since the beginning. Early on, Uber tried to price Lyft out of the market. They tried to eliminate them. That didn't work. And they've also dropped prices since then. And their main goal is to gain more passengers, but with a business model that is not sustainable long term. So what does this mean for other states? This is gonna be coming nationwide. It's just starting in California, but it's gonna spread everywhere. It's not gonna happen overnight. It's gonna happen eventually. This, quite frankly, could cripple Uber and Lyft. But the business model is what is here to stay. The business model, which is Rideshare, which is using an app to connect drivers and passengers. That business model is what people love. And yes, the prices, they may go up. On the passenger side, demand may go down. But the economics, the business model, as it stands today, does not work. Does not work long term. So with all that is going on right now, this is another wrench that's being thrown at the rideshare industry, at Uber and Lyft. They're going through enough anyways with the fact that their business is down so much. This is another thing that they have to deal with. Again, I think the main thing to remember is this is going to affect drivers nationwide eventually. It's going to come to your state. By the time that happens in some states, who knows if Uber or Lyft will even be operating. But the business model is here to stay, connecting drivers and riders. That model is here to stay. That is not going anywhere. But what do you guys think of this lawsuit? How do you think it will affect other states? And when do you think it will affect other states? Thanks again for watching, guys. Hope you're all staying sane and stay healthy. Thanks.